And then, you know, when I saddle one, I've hardly ever had a problem. Not to say I couldn't, but I just want to do it just like I've done it every day of their life, like it's just supposed to happen, you know. So that's how I saddle a horse every day, and that's how I want to saddle them. So that's always how I'm going to approach everything. You know, I'm going to, you know, approach everything how I want to do it eventually, but I'm going to pay attention to the horse. And, you know, if they tell me otherwise, if I pick up on something that they're bothered by it, then I might address that, or, you know, kind of work at things that might prepare him for that next step, you know. So if I went to swing that saddle up there and she jumped around or looked real worried, then, you know, I might have, you know, kind of swung it around or had to sack her out with that pad a little bit more than they did. Well, cinch her up. I think she'll be pretty comfortable. I'm touching her where that cinch goes with the back of my hand, so I'm not just surprising her with it. Now I'm kind of entering the point of no return. I always like to take 3 wraps if I can, because if she were to get uncomfortable here and jump, hopefully the saddle has a chance to stay where it's supposed to. I've already been on and off of her. She's real comfortable with it. You know, I'm just gonna have Connor get her set up, you know, maybe over by the fence closer, you know, so if she takes off when he does get on, we kind of know which way she's going. But, you know, I want her to just stand there. We worked on that with the hobbles. So he's just gonna kind of get her ready for him to get on and just get on, and then we'll just go from there. You know, he tightened his cinch up there and he did the right thing. He moved her just to make sure that that didn't surprise her. You know, it probably wasn't going to, but some horses it can, especially if you get a real cinchy one. You know, if you cinch one up, you always want to move them off a step again. Don't just step up there. So now he's just going to take a little feel of her nose, just like she did when I took the hobbles off the first time we saddled her. Kind of let her kind of step around there. We'll just let her step around a minute, kind of get used to his weight, take a hold of her again. When you get a spot, let's go the other way. Connor's gonna just sit up there and keep moving and stay loose. I'm helping her go, but his movement will kind of help her too. Go ahead and keep banging your legs on her a little bit. Okay, let her come back. Just hold, wait for her feet. Take a hold of her again. Just wait for those feet to come. There you go, now turn her loose. You know, a lot of times people, you gotta kind of set them up for some of this stuff, and you know, we're gonna take a hold of them, but you gotta wait for that softness to come. You can't just expect it to come right away all the time. You know, you gotta offer them that pressure and release, you know, and so we put a little pressure on, but then sometimes you gotta wait on them to get out of that bind, you know, and I think they're gonna learn more that way if you're patient enough to wait on it. Good. Okay. Wait. Okay. You know, as soon as you feel her feet come, that's when you gotta release. So go ahead and take a hold of her again. Go around one more time. I don't care if she lopes again now. I think she proved to me that she could do it. She did it well and softly. Just gonna trot around each way now. Just go ahead and take her and switch directions. Good. Already got a little turnaround on her. You know, one thing I'd like to see him do is maybe pat her on the butt. Sometimes we forget to do that, and then 6 rides from now, we reach down to pat them because they're doing good and we scare them, you know. So I want to use this round bend to my advantage if I'm going to use one. so I can kind of get all that out of the way. So now let her go ahead. She's being good. Let her come back. Now I just work on getting her to bend a little bit here or there. And, you know, I wouldn't even, now just take her nose and let her bend, you know. Don't worry about her feet moving. Just wait on those feet to stop. I'm going to start to teach her some of this lateral flexion now.